Hey guys, Michael Tingloff here today in Pasadena to check out Bistro 45, a restaurant with history just as tasty as its dishes. Let's take a look. Bistro 45 is the best French-American restaurant in the Pasadena area. It has a wide variety of tantalizing dishes, but what I love the most is the warm customer service. They always know what I want. Put it on my tab.
Can't you hear that Peter Pan? The atmosphere around Bistro 45 is warm and inviting. Everything about the environment reflects the quality of the establishment.
And after talking with members of the staff, it's quite apparent that Bistro 45 fosters a friendly working environment. The employees are like one big family. So what do you do for the restaurant?
I wait tables. I've been doing this here for 17 years now.
And how did you find the job here?
Through a friend. I came to visit him one night. He used to work here. His name was John King. And he said that they're looking for a waiter, so I jumped on.
Do you have a favorite memory here at the restaurant?
I don't know if I have a favorite memory, but it's a lot of fun. You know, it's like working with a family, you know. We've all known each other for so long that it makes it that much easier, you know.
Bistro 45 is an excellent and diverse restaurant. Everything from its duck breast to rack of lamb. I also love its customer service and friendly atmosphere. Its history is also incredible.
We got a chance to sit down with owner Richard Simon to take a dive into the early days of Bistro 45.
Thank you so much, Richard.
Michael, nice to see you.
Nice to see you too. Now just start us off. Did you found a Bistro 45?
I founded Bistro 45 with a team of investors and my wife, who at the time was only my fiance, back in 1990, before you were even a thought.
And what made you decide to get into the restaurant business?
Started in the restaurant business when I was 16 years old. I really, really always wanted to be part of that world. 16 years old, I was just bussing tables, but I loved to see people with smiles on their faces in the restaurants that I was working at. So when I went away to school to go to Berkeley, I continued to work all the way through college, all the way through all 5 years. I spent 5 years up there.
Now, do you have some fond memories of when you were first starting out in this restaurant?
No, actually, I hate every day that I'm here. No, I'm all kidding aside. If I didn't love this, I wouldn't be doing it for 30 years here in Pasadena and for more than 40 years of my life. But it's a grind. It's 7 days a week, seven nights a week. You know, Max sees me, unfortunately hears me, having to take phone calls 7 days, seven nights a week, texting, emailing. People are able to get a hold of me at all hours of the day because it's necessary to run your business. So anyway, those happy moments really have a lot more to do with what we can provide for people when they come in the restaurant. You know, the big days of the year, Mother's Days and Valentine's Days and Christmas Eves and New Year's Eves, those are more hard work, and it's very much more difficult to provide memorable times for people on those days. It tends to be more of the finite special occasions, the smaller ones or the smaller groups and gatherings. And I tell you, these walls, after 24 years, they resonate. They actually, you could feel in this restaurant all those memories from all those people and having all those great times.
Now, you said that Bistro 45 has been open for
24, almost 25 years.
25 years. What do you think has made Bistro so successful?
I think it's the fact that we really care deeply about what people experience when they come here. And it goes from the kitchen, which you're filming with some of the dishes that we make, and it goes to all the ingredients that are done with care, no shortcuts taken, everything done the right way, to the service pattern here, to people that have worked here. We have some people that have worked here, Michael, for 24 years, the entire time the restaurant's been open. We have a waiter over there named Mehdi who has been with us for 15 years, going on 30. I mean, he might as well have been here before the restaurant was built, because he brings to each individual people's dining experience something personal. He treats everybody well, but if you came in and he knew you, he's going to treat you as if you're someone special. But if you came in and he didn't know you, we're all going to give you an extra welcome because you're here for the first time and we want to get to know you. Other restaurants talk about doing that. Lots of restaurants talk the talk about service and something memorable, but we walk it. And we do it in such a way, I believe, that people think about us. Like I said, you have to think about us. They can't just drive by our restaurant. And that's what makes them come back.
It was great to see the kind of love and dedication he has put into this restaurant, and the staff shows it. It's obvious they care for each and every person who walks through those doors. And of course, we had to ask the ever-important question.
Have you had any, like, maybe celebrities or movie stars come into your Bistro 45 in the 25 years it's been open?
Well, we just lost somebody that was really amazing for the world at large, and that was Nelson Mandela. So in our restaurant, one day, we actually had, through All Saints Church, we had Bishop Desmond Tutu and we had Nelson Mandela here at the same time, both eating, both smiling, both having a great time, and everybody in the room picked up that energy. That was amazing to me. The other person who was so significant to me coming here, I mean, I told Max about people like the coach of the Pittsburgh Steelers or Roger Clemens coming here or some other great athletes like Joe Montana coming here to have dinner. Those are all kind of cool things. Stars and celebrities coming here are cool things. We've had Steven Spielberg here. We've had lots of other big Hollywood celebrity types. But I love comedy. So George Carlin, which is way before your time as well, was one of the greatest minds for comedy ever. He came in one night when we were sold out for a party of 120 people. We told him that, but I said, you mean so much to me, I'm gonna make a table for you. And we set him over in the far corner of the restaurant, just him and his wife for dinner at 5:30. There was nobody else, not a soul in the whole place, just him. He finished his meal, he thanked me, gave me a big hug, asked me for my address. 2 days later, a copy of his new book he had just written, called Brain Droppings, arrived at my house with an inscription from him inside the cover of the book, thanking me for the great meal, thanking me for the great experience, and thanking us for the love that the restaurant showed him. Unfortunately, a year later, he passed away. But we got the experience to have him here at this restaurant, and he just lit the whole place up, and there was nobody else in it. He was an amazing presence.
Well, thank you for your time, Mr. Simon.
Thank you, Michael. Take care.
After learning more about the history and the people behind the restaurant, it was time to check out what really makes Bistro 45 shine, the food. This was my first experience in the Bistro 45 kitchen, and boy, I'll tell you, I was more than impressed.
Hey, Ryan.
Hi.
How's it going?
All right.
What will we be Chris, making for us today?
Yeah. Chris is gonna make you the beef pizza. Here's Chris.
Hey, Chris.
Hi.
Could you go ahead and tell us about the pizza you're gonna be making today?
Basically, we're gonna be making a savory pizza, kind of like southwestern, kind of basically ground beef. It's a Chef Ryan's creation. Basically, it's filet ground with some crushed pepper and spices. And then we have our sauce that we put on there. It's basically a guajillo sauce. Basically, it's dried pepper that is boiled down. We use the juices. Then we puree it with a little bit of garlic. Brian has this inside scoop of that, but we can't give away too much details, right? So we'll go ahead and make it.
All right, fantastic.
So now our crust, set out. Put into our stone oven. Pre-bake our dough a little bit. So that way when we cook it, it gets nice crisp at the bottom. A lot of flavor in there. So we go ahead and put a little bit of our guajillo sauce on there. Nice spicy and savory, not too hot, but very delicious. Little mozzarella cheese. So, we put a little bit of our filet on there. So,
then we go ahead and throw that in here.
Get a nice char on it. Wait till the cheese is nice and melted.
Get a little golden brown on there.
And we're done.
I gotta say, watching make that pizza made me realize just how hungry I was. One down, three to go. You can really taste how savory the meat is they use for the topping here. Two down. You can really taste the salmon really mixing well with the cheese. It's a very nice blend. I really can't wait to take a second bite of this. It's still...
Bistro 45 reminds us what a restaurant should be, a place where people come for the full dining experience, a place where chefs can take pride in their work, a place where people really care.
Bistro 45.
Bistro 45.
Bistro 45.
Bistro 45, greatest restaurant in town.
Well, I had a fantastic time. Bistro 45 offers amazing food, warm service, and fantastic prices. I definitely will be back soon, and I hope you guys will join me. I'm Michael Tingloff, signing off.
But I'm not afraid, baby. My robot, if I never ever sense